Welcome to St. Andrew's Institute of Technology and Management. This college is affiliated to Maharshi Dayanand University, Rohtak, and approved by All India Council for Technical Education. This video lecture is a part of series developed for online classes. Hello everyone, my name is Ashish Tripathi and I am working as an assistant professor at St. Andrew's Institute of Technology and Management since 2015. My areas of interest are data analysis and data visualization, which are recommended to be a data scientist. Logical Organization of Computer. It is a course in Maharshi Dayanand University for the BCA second semester. This course comprises of the flip-flops, registers, counters, and memory circuits. So let's study about this course from the Unit 1. In this lecture of Unit 2, we will study about the shift registers, SISO, SIPO, PISO, PIPO, bidirectional and universal shift registers. Shift registers. The shift register is another type of sequential logic circuit that can be used for the storage or the transfer of data in the form of binary numbers. This sequential device loads the data present on its inputs and then moves or shifts it to its output once every clock cycle, hence the name shift register. A shift register basically consists of several single bit D-type data latches, one for each data bit, either a logic 0 or a 1. Connected together in a serial type daisy chain arrangement so that the output from one data latch becomes the input of the next latch and so on. The number of individual data latches required to make up a single shift register device is usually determined by the number of bits to be stored. Shift registers are used for data storage or for the movement of data and are therefore commonly used inside calculators or computers to store data such as two binary numbers before they are added together or to convert the data from either a serial to parallel or parallel to serial format. Shift register ICs are generally provided with a clear or a reset connection so that they can be set or reset as required. Generally, shift registers operate in 1 or 4 different modes, with the basic movement of data through a shift register being serial in to parallel out, that is SIPO. The register is loaded with serial data one bit at a time, with the stored data being available at the output in the parallel form. Second is serial in to serial out, that is SISO. The data is shifted serially in and out of the register one bit at a time in either a left or right direction under the clock control. Third one is parallel in to serial out, that is PISO. In this, the parallel data is loaded into the register simultaneously and is shifted out of the register serially one bit at a time under the clock control. The fourth one is parallel in to parallel out, that is PIPO. The parallel data is loaded simultaneously into the register and transferred together to their respective output by the same clock pulse. Here you can see a diagram depicting all these four conditions. We have four flip-flop in which on the extreme left hand side there is a serial data input D, and on the extreme right hand side we have the serial data output Q. In the bottom side we can see the parallel data input lines, likewise D0, D1, D2 and D3. Similarly, we have the parallel data output lines on the top of this, likewise Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q3. This type of diagram is easy to understand about all these four shift registers. Serial in to parallel out, SIPO shift register. Here is a diagram depicting the 4-bit serial in parallel out shift register. Here all the flip-flop, that is FFA to FFD, have just been reset or clear, and that all the outputs QA to QD are at logic 0. First clock pulse. In the first clock pulse, if a logic 1 is connected to the data input pin of FFA flip-flop, then the output of the FFA, that is QA, will be set high to the logic 1, with the all other output still remaining low at the logic 0. Hence, we get the parallel output as 1, 0, 0, 0. Second clock pulse. It will change the output of FFA to logic 0 and the output of the FFB, that is QB, to logic 1, as its input D has the logic 1 level on it from QA. The logic 1 has now moved or been shifted one place along the register to the right, as it is now at QB. So the parallel output will be 0, 1, 0, 0. So you have seen that whatever was the output of the QA, that is the first flip-flop, now it has been supplied to the as an input to the second flip-flop, and now the second flip-flop outputs 1 correspondingly. Similarly, in the third clock pulse, the logic 1 will move to the flip-flop number C, and we have the parallel output as 0, 0, 1, 0, and in the fourth clock pulse, the logic 1 will move to FFD, and now the QD will having the high output, so the parallel output will be 0, 0, 0, 1. On applying the fifth clock pulse, it will set all the outputs QA to QD back to the logic level 0, because the input to flip-flop number A has remained the constant at the logic level 0. So after applying the fifth clock pulse, the parallel output will be 0, 0, 0, 0. Commonly available SIPO IC include the standard 8-bit 74LS164 or the 74LS594 IC circuits. Serial in to serial out, SISO shift register. This shift register is very similar to SIPO, except where before the data was read directly in the parallel form from the output QA to QD, this time the data is allowed to flow straight through the register and out of the other end. Since there is only one output, the data leaves the shift register one bit at a time in a serial pattern. Hence the name serial in to serial out shift register, or SISO. The SISO shift register is one of the simplest of the four configuration, as it has only three connections. The serial input SI, which determines what enters the left side, and the left side of the flip-flop, the serial output SO, which is taken from the output of the right-hand flip-flop, and the sequencing clock CLK. Here is a 4-bit serial into serial out shift register. In this you can see that the data enters from the extreme left-hand side, that is FFA flip-flop, and continuously it follows through FFB, FFC, and finally it goes out from the FFD flip-flop. Hence there is a serial movement of the data. SISO flip-flop act as a temporary storage device, or it can act as a time delay device for the data. Commonly available IC include 74HC595, which is a 8-bit serial in serial out shift register with all the 3 state output. Parallel in to serial out PISO shift register. The parallel in to serial out shift register act in the opposite way to the serial into parallel out shift register. The data is loaded into the register in a parallel format in which all the data bits enter their input simultaneously to the parallel input pins PA to PD of the register. The data is then read out sequentially in the normal shift right mode from the register at Q, representing the data present at PA to PD. This data is outputted 1 bit at a time on each clock cycle in a series format. It is important to note that with this type of data register, a clock pulse is not required to parallel load the register as it is already present, but 4 clock pulses are required to unload the data as we have to move the data from the each flip-flop to the right-hand side so that we can get it out. Also, you can see in the diagram we have a multiplexer for the input of the flip-flop so that each of the bit, that is PA, PB, PC and PD, will rectify their input against the one logic and the previous output of the flip-flop. There are 2 modes in which this circuit can work, namely shift mode or load mode. In the load mode, when the shift load bar line is low, that is the input line to the shift load is 0, the AND gates, namely 2, 4, 6, become active and they will pass the B1, B2 and B3 bits to the correspondingly flip-flops. On the low going edge of the clock, the binary input bits B0, B1, B2, B3 will get loaded into the corresponding flip-flop. Thus, parallel loading takes place. In the shift mode, when the shift load bar line is high, that is the input is 1, the AND gate 2, 4, 6 became inactive, hence the parallel loading of the data becomes impossible. But the AND gates 1, 3 and 5 becomes active, therefore the shifting of data from left to right bit by bit on the application of clock pulse take place. It can be used to multiplex many different input lines into a single serial data stream, which can be sent directly to a computer or transmitted over a communication line. Commonly available IC include the 74HC166, which is a 8-bit parallel in serial out shift register. Parallel in to parallel out PIPO shift register. The parallel in to parallel out shift register also act as a temporary storage device or as the time delay device, similar to the SISO configuration. The data is presented in a parallel format to the parallel input pins P PA to PD and then transferred together directly to their respective output pins QA to QD by the same clock pulse. Then one clock pulse loads and unloads the register. The PIPO shift register is the simplest of the four configuration as it has only three connections. The parallel input pin, that is PI, which determines what enters the flip-flop. The parallel output pins PO, which determines from where the output will be given, and the sequencing clock signal CLK. Similar to the serial in to serial out shift register, this type of register also act as a temporary storage device or as the time delay device. Also, in this type of register, there are no interconnections between the individual flip-flop since no serial shifting of the data is required. So here you can see in the figure that in one clock pulse, the data will be entered by the pins PA, PB, PC and PD into the correspondingly flip-flop number A, B, C and D, and in the next clock cycle, the output from these flip-flop, namely QA, QB, QC and QD, will be read from the flip-flop. Bidirectional shift register. If a binary number is shifted left by one position, then it is equivalent to multiplying the original number by 2. Similarly, if a binary number is shifted right by one position, then it is equivalent to dividing the original number by 2. Hence, if we want to use the shift register to multiply and divide the given binary number, then we should be able to move the data in either left or right direction. Such a register is called the bidirectional register. There are two serial input, namely the serial write data shift data input, that is DR, and the serial left shift data input DL, along with a mode select input M. In the diagram, we can see that there is a mode control bit M whose value can vary from 0 and 1. When the value of the M is 1, then it will perform the shift write operation. Because when the value of M is 1, then the AND gates 1, 3, 5 and 7 are active, whereas the remaining gates 2, 4, 6 and 8 will be disabled. Then the data at the DR, which is at the extreme left hand side, is shifted to right side bit by bit from FF3 to FF0 on the application of the clock pulse. Hence, with M equals to 1, we get the serial write shift operation. Similarly, when M equals 0, then there is a shift left operation. When the mode control bit is 0, then the AND gates 2, 4, 6 and 8 will become active while the 1, 3, 5 and 7 are disabled. So the data at DL, that is the extreme right hand side, is shifted left bit by bit from FF0 to FF3 on the application of the clock pulse. Hence, with M equals 0, we get the serial write shift operation. Universal shift register. Today, there are many high-speed bidirectional universal type shift register available, such as the TTL74LS194 and 74LS195 or the CMOS 4035, which are available as a 4-bit multifunction device that can be used in either serial to serial left shifting, right shifting, serial to parallel, parallel to serial, or as a parallel to parallel multifunction data register. Hence, it is named as universal shift register. These universal shift register can perform any combination of parallel and serial input to output operation, but require additional inputs to specify the desired function and to preload and reset the device. A commonly used universal shift register is the TTL74LS194, which is shown below. Here you can see that there are two control bits, namely S0 and S1. When the value of S1, S0 is 00, then the shift register will be holding the data. When the mode bit is 01, then it is used for shifting to the right hand side. When the mode bit is 10, it is shifting to the left hand side. And when the mode bit is 11, then the universal shift register is performing in the parallel mode. Here you can see that the bit number 2 is used for serial data shift right, and bit number 7 is used for serial data left input. Similarly, the pins form 3, 4, 5 and 6, namely PA, PB, PC and PD, are used for parallel data input, and the pins 12, 13, 14, 15, namely QD, QC, QB and QA, are used for parallel data output. We have the clock pulse at the pin number 11 and the VCC voltage at the pin number 16. We have a grounding voltage at the pin number 8, and the clear instruction will be given to the IC at pin number 1. With this, we come to end of this session. So questions for today's session are: what are shift registers? Next question is, draw and explain SISO, SIPO, PISO and PIPO shift registers. Third question is, explain the bidirectional and universal shift register. Thanks for watching the video. In this video, you have learned about the shift registers and the various type of shifting, like serial into serial out, serial into parallel out, parallel into parallel out and parallel into serial out. Also, you have gone through to the universal shift register and bidirectional shift register. Now, we will cover the counters in the next video. Till then, goodbye and take care.